Good morning. My name is Nikos Karavidas, and I'm a physiotherapist coming from Greece. The research is about the brace treatment for adolescent idiopathic scoliosis and Sherman kyphosis, the issue of overtreatment in Greece. According to the SRS, brace indication for scoliosis treatment is for curves above 25 degrees at races 0 to 3. For Sherman kyphosis, brace indication is for cob angle between 55 and 80 degrees, races 0 to 3, with Sherman findings on X-ray. And the brace weaning phase should start at race 4, approximately 2 years post-menage for girls. Short guidelines are slightly different. So they say that we could brace between 20 and 25 degrees based on the risk of progression on the Lowenstein formula. Overtreatment is defined as any healthcare provided with higher volume or cost than the appropriate. In our study, it is the unnecessary use of brace. So it includes subjects that should have never started brace treatment or that should have finished earlier. Parameters measured were cob angle, race sign, age of menage, and Sherman vertebra wedging on X-ray. In some borderline cases, we also evaluated other risk prognostic factors such as trunk and vertebral rotation, hypokyphosis, family history, and curve type. 167 subjects were finally included in our study. Most of them were females with scoliosis. It is also important to say that a brace prescription was made by 34 medical doctors from different geographical areas of Greece. The results showed that 42.5% of the patients had received some kind of overtreatment, with the results being slightly higher for the scoliosis group. A further analysis for the scoliosis group revealed that 16.9% of the patients had cob angle below 20 degrees, 5.9% had cob angle between 20 and 25 degrees, but good prognosis. 10.2% of the patients started brace treatment after race 4, and 10.2% did not reach brace weaning at race 4. I would also like to pinpoint that 6.8% of the patients had cob angle below 20 degrees at race 5, but they were prescribed a brace. As we know from the Lowenstein and Carlson study, about the natural history of scoliosis, the incidence of progression for curves below 20 degrees at reset 0, at reset 2 to 4 is just 1.6%. The analysis for the kyphosis group showed that 22.5% had no Sherman findings on the X-ray, 6.1% started brace treatment after reset 4, and 12.2% had no brace weaning. I'm going to shortly present some of the cases. This is a 16-year-old girl, race 4, with a curve of 18 degrees, brace prescription for 20 hours. Race 5, 18 degrees, 4 years and a half post-menage, still in brace. 17-year-old with a very mild scoliosis of 16 degrees, 4 years post-menage, still in brace at race 5. 15-year-old, race 4, cob angle 15 degrees, brace prescription for 18 hours. 14-year-old, 14 degrees, race 3, brace prescription full time 22 hours. 10-year-old with a cob angle below 10 degrees, but brace prescription for 12 hours. So to conclude, an extremely high rate of overtreatment was observed in the brace treatment for adolescent idiopathic scoliosis and Sherman kyphosis in Greece. Possible explanations for this could be the ignorance of the SRS guidelines, the ignorance of the important role of the physiotherapeutic scoliosis-specific exercises in the treatment of mild scoliosis with cob angle below 25 degrees, poor education, other non-scientific reasons. What we certainly know is that overtreating a child with a brace can cause serious psychosocial problems to them. This is the study I mentioned before about physiotherapeutic scoliosis-specific exercises. It is a randomized controlled trial by Monticone and his colleagues, published in 2014 in European Spine Journal. The authors concluded that scoliosis-specific exercises can reduce the risk of progression in mild scoliosis and have significantly better results than general exercises. So to provide the optimal care for the patient, according to this table, we have to stay in this diagonal line, because if we are above this, we overtreat the patient. If we are below this diagonal line, we undertreat the patient. Thank you for your attention.